Okay, so there's going to be many people in your life that are going to want to challenge you, so to speak. And it's not necessarily a bad thing. Sometimes it's good. It's good to test your character. It's good to see how much you've healed. It's good to see how you handle certain situations. Now, from what I've learned, people that do things, let's say step over your boundaries, and then you call them out on it, and then they turn around and look at you and they're like, I don't know what you're talking about, or what exactly are you talking about, like, and then you give them an example, say, okay, well, I did say I appreciate this or do this, right? And they turn around and they come up with some excuse. Don't even fucking explain yourself. It's a waste of time. They're setting you up. It's a setup. So what you need to do is you need to put your foot down immediately. You need to let them know that you do not believe that they're stupid, and that you've already had discussions before on whatever it is that you need to talk about. Just remember that these individuals that constantly, now this could almost be me talking about myself, but I think there's different kind of context, just like how you say a phrase, and it could be taken in two different ways. So for this specific example, an individual wants to no longer deal with you anymore because you've called them out on certain things after they stepped over your boundary line. So you call them out and you're like, I didn't appreciate that. So they're like, okay, well, I'm not gonna deal with you or talk to you anymore. And that's fine. They have all right to do so. They must have gotten to a point. It's possible they could feel very uncomfortable. You dropped something. Excuse me. Anyways, what was I saying? Okay, get back to the point. You're welcome. Yeah. Anyways, so there's going to be people in your life that test you. And a lot of the times, and this is how I can use an example for me, is when I was younger, I used to dislike certain authority or people telling me what to do, because I had a lot of people around me that were more so like hypocrites. So they would tell me not to do something or tell me to do something, and then they would do the exact opposite of it, okay? So in this circumstance, this is a grown adult to a grown adult, not a grown adult to a child. Technically, mentality, it shouldn't count, but I take it into consideration. So these individuals are usually used to not being held accountable. Let's say they're coddled as a young child and they get away. I'm not saying every child, but they get away with doing something. Let's say their mom or their dad never disciplined them. They never were held accountable. There was always excuses given to them. Whatever it is to make this child believe that they don't have to be accountable for their own actions, okay? So now these children specifically, it's not that they're bad children. It's not there's anything wrong with them. It's just nature versus nurture, right? And their upbringing but made them believe that they weren't supposed to be held accountable for anything. So almost like your typical stereotype of like a spoiled child almost, even if they're not spoiled, right? A typical stereotype of that, where they walk around and you know, they could hurt people or steal from people or take from people or expect certain things, right? And they're never held accountable. So in this circumstance, it is myself placing a boundary down and then saying, let's say it's my home or my vehicle, you know, certain rules apply to this vehicle or certain rules apply to this home. Please respect those. And then a person stepping over the boundary line and purposefully, now I say purposefully, it'd be like after the second, third time. If you have stated something and you, I think I made a video about this already. If you've stated something already and they step over it third, fourth, fifth, that's not an accident. In my experience, that's never usually an accident. Usually it's done purposefully. One, either to get your attention out of a negative response so that they could flip it on you in some way if you lose your temper. Or if you don't lose your temper, it's still them gaining some sort of attention. Two, it could be they don't like or respect anybody telling them what to do because they don't feel that they have to reciprocate that or listen in any way. And that's fine. With all due respect to those people, that's fine. If you do not feel you have to listen to somebody, that's fine. But when it comes to me setting my boundaries and you disrespect those, you're disrespecting me. And so I'm not okay with that. Now, this individual that I dealt with, they want to go their separate way, and that's more than okay. I'm happy with that, and I respect that. I do not appreciate somebody using the whole idea that they're dumb. It doesn't work. When I have called them out on it and they say, oh, I don't know what you're talking about. What exactly did you tell me again? What did we discuss? Like playing like they're dumb. It doesn't work with me. So, it's almost like a compliment, but it's also me holding you accountable for it. So if you've ever experienced this in your life, it's quite possible that they could have been coddled. They could have been used to not having to take accountability. They could also not like taking any rules or they don't want to listen to what you have told them, even if it is logically reasonable, because for some reason it's like an ego battle. It's like challenging a person and wanting to see how much they can gaslight them or get away with certain things. Because it's almost like if they get away with this after you've asked them not to, then you're going back on your word for yourself. You're going back on your boundaries that you place, and almost like in some way they win, which is a little bit skewed, if you ask me. It's a strange concept, but in itself is just an ego battle. It's them feeling that they're superior in some way. It's them gaining some sort of control. If they feel out of control themselves, it's them gaining some sort of power over the relationship when it's not necessarily, it doesn't need to be that way. It's not necessary at all. In my case, I don't feel like I was unjust or unfair. I don't feel like I set any boundaries or rules for my home that were obscure or unreasonable. And so, unfortunately, it comes time to go our separate ways, and that's okay. That is really okay. So if you've ever experienced this, just know that fighting a person and trying to convince them to remember something when they know full well what they're doing, like they know what they've done, they know what they've said, they know what they went against. Most times a person asks you to repeat yourself. If it happens more than twice, three times, it's no longer asking you to repeat yourself. It's just making you feel like you don't know what you're talking about. It's gaslighting, basically. And it's toxic trait. And it's not acceptable at all. So, just make sure you keep your cool. Don't panic. Don't freak out. Don't let them bully you. Don't let them shit on your boundaries and expect you to clean it up, okay?